Alrighty guys, in today's video, we are going to be going over one thing that's probably the most important part of a skier's full setup, and that is going to be our ski boots here. Pretty much what I'm gonna go over with is, first of all, the right way to put the boots on. I'm gonna go over a bunch of different adjustments that you can make to the boot with different spacers and bin boards and stuff like that. But yeah, let's get right into it. Alrighty, and then the boots that I'm using here as my example today are some Dalbello Lupo 130s, 130 flex in them, meaning they're a very stiff boot, mainly a backcountry and touring focused boot, but I use these as my day-to-day boot. What I always go by is whatever boot feels best and rides best on your everyday basis is definitely what you want to go with. Alrighty, and then the first thing I'm going over real quick is just the right way to put a boot on. Believe it or not, there is a right and wrong way. The number one rule though is that whenever you are not wearing your boot or keeping it in storage or whatever it is, you definitely want to make sure to have it fully buckled up like so. If you leave it fully unbuckled over a long period of time, the plastic on the boots will tend to begin to flare up, warp, affect the overall shape of the boot, and you don't want that at all. And obviously before you even put the boot on, you're gonna need a nice pair of ski socks. These are just some smart wool extra thicks. You're gonna wanna have those as high up as possible. You never wanna ride in anything but ski socks. It definitely helps protect your shins and obviously keep your feet warm as well. But yeah, then you're gonna wanna start breaking the boot down, obviously. All right, and now that you got the boot fully broken down, fully unbuckled here, first thing you can go ahead and do is just grab that tongue right here, just pull it straight up out of the boot. That'll make it the easiest to put on here, and then just slide your foot in just like so. And then as soon as you put that boot on, first thing you're gonna wanna make sure is that this tongue piece is nice and centered, right in the middle, not off to the side like that or that, just right here in the middle. And then mine have this tether to tighten my insole down, but not all boots have that. Doesn't really make a difference anyways. But then after I do all that, the first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and give my foot a couple kicks straight to the heel. That just sets your heel right to the back of the boot, gets the right fit that you want in the boot overall. And then you always wanna start off right here at the ankles. And then you never wanna go all the way tight or as tight as you can right away. You always wanna start at one of these first notches here on your buckles. And then you just kind of cycle back through each buckle here and just go a little bit more each time. All right, and then lastly, this booster strap here, get that as tight as possible and she's on your foot. But as far as tightness goes with the boot, I always like to have my boot pretty much as tight as possible. Any wiggling room that you have in the boot will definitely cause for some uncomfort, maybe even some blisters throughout the day. So definitely better to have it, it's more uncomfortable on the tight side than on the loose side. All right, now I'm gonna be going over just a couple ways that you can use spacers and make some adjustments to the overall fit of the boot with spacers. And this will help you just adjust your overall center of gravity and just help you be a little more comfortable on the hill. So the first thing we're gonna need to do here is obviously take the liner out of the boot. So go ahead, unbuckle everything. And just like when you put it on before, you pull that tongue out and then grab the shell right there and then just pull that liner right out. Alrighty, and now that I've got that liner out, I can start looking at some adjustments that I can make with spacers here. One thing that I personally deal with is I have very skinny legs, so that just adds a little extra room for my legs to move around within most ski boots. So what I do to combat that is I use this spacer right here. If you do have a pair of Dalbello boots, most Dalbello boots will come with one of these. However, if you don't have Dalbello boots, they might not come with it. I'll go ahead and leave a link in the description for some alternative options for that. But pretty much what the gist is with this is I put it about as low as possible. That pretty much pushes my calf as forward into the boot as possible. Also puts more of my weight on my toes. That's just how I like to ride as well. But really helps with just decreasing that extra space inside my boot as well. And then some other spacers that you can add to the liner of the boot that will help the fit. This is what I use for my flat feet personally, is these what I call bin boards. So I actually run two pairs of bin boards. They're also called insole shims, but I like to call them bin boards. Get it out, there we go. So I run two pairs of these in each boot, obviously. What these pretty much do is just raise my feet a little bit higher off from the bottom of the boot, also decreasing that amount of extra area above the top of my foot. These really just help tighten down the boot and just cause for a more comfortable fit and more snug fit while I'm going down the hill as well. And I will go ahead and leave a link in the description for these as well. Alrighty guys, and before I let you all go, there is one more product that I would recommend for you all, and that would be the booster strap. Essentially what it is a strap that you replace your old strap that goes right on your shin with. And it essentially has a bungee tether on it that allows your shin to have more forward travel and as well as backward rebound for a little bit more poppy of a boot. Thanks for tuning in to Dizzy Skis. See you guys on the slopes.